Well, one man who sat here, like the rest of us, absolutely fascinated by that weightlifting competition, was a man you may have caught a glimpse of in the audience, and a man you've certainly seen if you watch World Superstars from the Bahamas, because he's twice World Superstar champion from Canada, Brian Bubb. Brian, nice to see you in the UK. What is this, holiday? You're spying on the British.
Oh, I'm not really spying. I've come over to see a very good friend of mine and spent some time with him and snuck over to Sweden for a while. And of course, I got in touch with the office over here and found out when the finals were going to be, just so I can check up on the UK competition for next year, you know?
You couldn't resist the temptation to come in and see.
No, I've heard you've got some great athletes here, and by the past performances of today, I'll tell you what, they're more than good, they're great.
Gym test coming up, of course, your speciality, squat thrust, with the technique that we've got out in the States, out there, where you drag your feet and everything else. You been teaching any of the boys here that?
Well, they call it a technique, but for me, the way it developed, it was just the easy way out. It was like, you know, the hardest part for me was getting the legs back and forth, so I just kind of dragged them. Unless you have to lift them, it's so as far as a speciality goes, I don't train much for it. It's, I guess the soccer is very, very good for it, and it carries me through it. Football, as we call it over here.
Yeah.
So speciality, I guess, but we do the chin-ups.
That's right.
As far as these dips go, I did them once 3 years ago in the Canadians and was horrified by my result. But
anyway, Brian, we'll be seeing you in the Bahamas in World Superstars.
I like to think so, and I like to think I'll see a few of these fellas down too, because every year the competition gets that much better, and looking at the results you've got here, by the way, it's, I might have a few nights and might not even get any rest. Well, I shouldn't say that.
You might drink a few more of those English pints, you're so
far. Oh, I'm not that way at all, you know.
Anyway, Brian, nothing against you. We wouldn't mind knocking you off your pedestal when we come out there again, but wish you luck, and it's good to see you over here.
Thanks very much, and look forward to all the competition these fellows are going to give me.
Brian Bud.
Steady.
12, 30.
Oh, 40, and strict judging that. 50, 60, he was docked one there.
70, 80, 90, 20, 21, 22.
He's done 28 in the past as Alan Minter. Finished second in the gym tests in his heat.
25.
30 seconds.
26, 27, 28.
Oh, that's his score.
20 seconds. 15.
A lot of character. Well, he gets one more than last time.
10.
29, I think he'll be given. John Williams on the bench. He scored 25. So he goes down one. And Danny Nightingale scored 26. So Alan Minter will be pleased with that as John Sherwood comes out. 34 John Sherwood did last time, and he's good at squat thrust, so he's looking for points here.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Peculiar pecking style. Needs strong abdominals as well as strong triceps, the arm extension muscles, to do it this way.
80, 90.
Oh, and he too has been docked one.
24.
Takes a little rest. Passes JJ Williams and Danny Nightingale. Matches Alan Minter. Goes into the lead.
20 seconds.
Look at the definition on this athlete.
15 seconds.
34, 35 now, John Sherwood.
10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Countdown may well rob him. As always, gives his all, John Sherwood. Scores 38. Brian Jacks sitting comfortably, the king of dips. The spotlight on Daley Thompson, still reveling in his weightlifting victory, but knows that Brian Jacks is just about untouchable in the gymnasium.
Right, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Did over 50 last time.
9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 70, 80, 90, 20, 1, 22, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
going well.
30, 1, 32, 33, 34, 35,
passes John Sherwood seconds, and goes into the lead. Now can he whittle 9, away 40, the potential 41, of Jack's? 42,
20 seconds.
Got a great following here, I must say. Oh, he's not going to do his 50. Seconds. 52 he had last time.
Oh, shit.
His own severest critic. Everybody waiting for Brian Jacks. We want 90. 90 plus. And Mum sits and watches, never misses a competition. Her whole family here. Brian Jacks checks to see that Daley Thompson and all others are watching as he starts the metronome. 76 last time out. 78 in last year's United Kingdom final.
5, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32.
And they're good
4,
dips.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30 seconds.
That's it, the lead.
3, 4.
Everyone
five,
now
six,
means
seven,
a squat
eight,
thrust less in order to win.
61,
the gym test, combined score,
five,
of course.
20, 60,
dips
60,
and squat thrusts.
71, 72,
15,
5, 7, 6, 7,
beats his
four,
UK
7, 8,
total.
10, 1, 8, 7,
getting roared
6,
on.
5, 4, 3,
oh,
2.
What are they going to give him? First time I've seen him exhausted inside the minute. Fantastic demonstration of arm strength.
Bring on Brian Budd.
Daley Thompson wants Brian Budd. See if he can match that score of 80. And I think he's coming. And the audience loving it. There's no way these guys can resist a challenge. Kicked his shoes off. And doesn't normally do this.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
This is the fella that does 50 chins.
6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4.
No, Brian Jacks thinks he's safe. But Daley Thompson, who made the invitation, may well be eating his heart out now. Yes, he's gone past Daley Thompson. Hasn't done it for 2 years. Thank you very much, he says. Well, just a light-hearted demonstration by the world superstar champion Brian Budd. But here's the real scores. Brian Jacks, a new superstar's record of 80 dips. Daley Thompson, 46. John Sherwood, 38. Alan Minter, 29. And when it came to the squat thrusts, Daley Thompson had his watch down in front and had to drive himself hard because he was being pressured by John Sherwood. He scored 73.
Brian Jacks.
Brian Jacks. Well, with a tremendous lead from his dips. He hardly needs to go through it, but he puts his orange down in the place of Daley Thompson's watch. And uncompromising as ever, as the entourage
ready,
call out for 90,
one, two,
he actually three, scored five, 73
seven,
in a minute.
Eight, nine, 40,
when he came to John Sherwood, he used the Budd technique,
four,
leaning right
five,
forward, dragging
six,
himself
seven,
on his toes.
Seconds,
and
nine,
he needed 82 to beat Daley Thompson and go into second place. That would be a remarkable
eight,
score,
nine,
one of the highest
six,
scores in superstars
seconds,
ever.
Three,
but watch this.
Four, five, six, seven,
There it is. In fact, he goes on for a magnificent 86, the highest score ever in Superstars at Squat Thrust, and well deserves his second place in the overall gym tests. Confirmation there, Brian Jacks the winner, a magnificent total of 153. John Sherwood second, 124. Daley Thompson has to settle for third place with 119 total.
So five events gone, Brian Jacks still there. He's never been off the top position, but John Sherwood now is a bigger threat than Daley Thompson.
Well, the news that John Sherwood has given up his amateur status to take part in this 100 metres will echo around the athletic world, because there hasn't been a better club athlete for the past 10 years than this man, who turns out week after week doing five or six events for his club in Sheffield. So, John, why the big decision?
Well, I didn't think I'd have to make it. The problem in the past Masters didn't arise because there was only one running event, and then having done a lot better than expected in that and qualified for this and found there were two running events, the problem then was to try and work out whether I could do swimming and do it well enough to compete. I've been virtually every day for a month and it's just not improved. I'm not a swimmer, it's as simple as that. And I wanted to enter this competition and do as well as possible, because I don't think it's worth going in for any competition if you don't try and do that. And this was the only other way.
John, the obvious question I have to ask you, how much was money a serious consideration?
Not a great deal, to be quite honest. Obviously, it's nice to get something at the end of, 13 or 14 years of top-class athletics.
And a glittering career.
Basically, in a competition, in any competition, I want to do as well as possible. And if I could have done the swimming reasonably well and thought I could, you know, give a good account of myself, then there's no way I would have taken this decision. But the swimming just didn't come on, and this was the only other alternative.
Well, JJ Williams is clearly the favourite, and John Sherwood has never believed that he could beat JJ Williams. He simply wants to do the best he possibly can, and it's that sort of motivation that makes him the athlete he is. Another fella he'll have to watch out for is Steve Ascinder, a big threat, and showed that he could do a little bit of running. Unfortunately, it's bad weather conditions for this start of the 100.
On your mark.
And they line up. Danny Nightingale on the left. Then Jeff Hurst, John Sherwood, JJ Williams, Steve Ascinder, and Alan Minter in lane one on the far right.
Set.
Away they go. JJ gets the start he expected. John Sherwood up. But so too is Steve Ascinder. Those two battling for second place. JJ clear away now. They're not going to close the gap. But look at the battle developing for second place. On the line, they're absolutely together. Magnificent run. John Sherwood knows that he's not a 100-meter sprinter, but boy, he battled all the way to the line. But was it him or was it Ascinder? JJ, 3 yards clear, but there on the line, and still we don't know. But the judges say it was John Sherwood in second place. Steve Ascinder has to settle for 4 points, but there was no doubt about the winner.